Hey everybody, Will is with Matt, the lead narrative director. Did I get that right?
Designer.
Designer. Yeah. With Gwent. Gwent, for those of you who played The Witcher 3, it's actually a game that exists inside of the game, and through apparently almost an outcry from fans to actually produce a standalone version of this game.
Yeah, exactly. We had like tons of, after we released The Witcher 3, we had like tons of emails, like messages on Twitter, Facebook. Some people even made their own fun versions of Gwent so they could play online.
They're already that into it.
Yes, exactly. So yeah, we decided to do it.
And you know, something that you guys would do is listen to your fans and listen to the feedback, and so out came Gwent, I guess.
Exactly.
So tell us some of the differences between the game, the actual version that's in the game, and the standalone version.
So first of all, it's a online competitive game now, so we had to rebalance it, like, you know, rebuild it from scratch.
Sure.
So the core principles are the same, the core set, but we have added a lot of new abilities, new mechanics, new cards, and so on. So every card is useful now, you know, so basically also the abilities fit the characters better. So for example, in the Skellige deck, we have added these cards that are like berserkers, kind of. So, you know, once they go into graveyard, and if you bring them back, they, you know, get angry and get stronger, basically.
Yeah.
So we have added a lot of that. And also we have changed the deck build a little bit. Because, as you might remember...
Right. You can become OP and just like demolish everything.
Exactly. You could like add, you know, all the heroes in your deck. And heroes, you know, are very strong cards.
You'd be unstoppable.
Exactly. They are resistant to the weather effects and special card abilities and so on. So right now you can add up to 4 of those in a deck. But, you know, because we could do that, we could keep them very special with some very special abilities, very strong and so on. So, you know, once you find one of those, you will be very, you know, happy and
With some, a little more strategy involved, obviously.
Exactly, yes. I mean, because of those new abilities and mechanics, there are a lot of more combos possible. And, you know, it adds a lot of depth to the deck building and, like I said, discovering different combos, you know, combining some strengths of the cards. Yeah, I think it's much better than it was.
Now, there is, obviously, the multiplayer you mentioned, but there is a campaign as well.
Yes, definitely. It's something I'm super excited about, something very special for me.
This was a big part of your role in this, right?
Exactly, because I worked as a lead quest designer on The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, so stories
are amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
So, as you might imagine, stories and quests are super important for me. So, when I moved to this team, the Gwent team in December last year, I was tasked with coming up, you know, with how the single player should look like in general. So, you know, I played a lot of hard games as well, and I played, for example, my Magic Clash of Heroes last year just to check them out, and I thought, why not do something more like hard game? I mean, because, you know, Gwent is Battle of Two Armies, so it gives us, you know, super interesting possibility to do stories about leaders that lead their armies and grow at them, right?
Yeah.
And as you might know, the Witcher games and the universe in general, the leaders, the kings and the queens are not your, you know, standard fantasy kings and queens. They are very witchery as well. So
witchery,
yes.
And the campaign itself, I mean, if someone's going to sit down and start this game, how long would it take them to go through it?
Each campaign will be around 10 plus hours.
Yeah. Which is obviously different every time.
Yes, definitely. Each of them will be tailored around a specific faction. So you can imagine them to be very unique and very different.
Yeah. And I can see a lot of people getting mad at each other online and the cooperative or the, you know, the online battles.
Yeah.
It'll be very interesting. But, you know, you mentioned for new players that aren't familiar with it, how long to get, you know, how much of a learning curve?
To be honest, I think the basics of the game are super simple, and I think it's like less than 15 minutes to learn it.
Yeah.
We have a dedicated tutorial mode, so you can basically learn those basics, and right after that you can get, you know, right into the action.
And then, this is essentially a strategy game, right?
Kind of, yeah.
I mean, you have to think James, one of our guys, says it's a thinking man's game, and I just can't wait to see how some of this plays out. Yeah, Dean looks amazing.
Thank
Matt, thank you so much for taking some time with us. I can't wait to play it. When is it officially released?
So we have announced on the Microsoft conference that the closed beta will launch in September for the PC and Xbox One. Closed beta for PS4 will be later.
Okay.
And the release date, well, you know, it depends on how will be the feedback we will get from the closed beta. So it's yet to be announced.
Check out Gwent when it's available. Go get this thing. See Project Red, just killing it. You guys are amazing.
You can already sign up for the beta.
It's a free game, right? It's also
yes, it's a free-to-play game with optional in-game purchases.
There you go. All right, thanks again, Matt. Really appreciate it. Keep it here on Press Start TV. We'll have more on Gwent coming soon.